Here from Aussie Tech, and today I've got this amazing rig here. I'm going to be using this rig to do most of this video, and what I'm going to show you is a new camera that I got hold of recently, which I think is one of the best cameras for vlogs. Now I've done a couple of them quite recently, and I still reckon that the Sony Action Cam is brilliant for vlogs, but there's certain things that you want in a vlog. Now 4K isn't important to most people, and I don't think it's really important for vlogs. So unless you need that, there's no point going the 4K route, and I personally think 4K is still a little bit when you want the stability, the lighting. Now, the camera that I'm using, I'm actually doing this part of the video with, is the new, well not really new, it's been out for a year, the Canon G5X. Now, it's my first Canon for a long time. My first ever Canon, well camera, my first ever digital camera was this, the Canon 300D. This camera really started off basically everything when it came to digital SLRs. This is basically the boy that started it all, and that was my first Canon. And I also had this tiny little pocket one, what do they call it, the Exus IXUS 60. It's hardly been used, it's well for a long time now. Great little camera, but what I'm going to do now is I'm going to show you some footage that I've recorded with the G5X, should I say, and I'm really impressed with it. It's a low light, incredible. The stabilization is one of the best I've seen. People have always commented about the colours on the Canon, and I must say I'm really digging their colours. Now the camera is a very interesting one. I was looking at getting the G7X Mark II, which is a slightly newer processor, but just couldn't get hold of them. And then I saw some information on the G5X, and I'm looking going, you know, that's got some specs that I'm more interested in, and also the form factor, because I also find these small cameras quite hard for me because I've got big hands, and the G5X is small enough what I needed, big enough for my hands. It's absolutely perfect as a small companion camera, and I think actually a very good vlog. So what, I'll stop talking now, let's go and have a look at the camera and then some footage from it, and I'll come back with some thoughts at the end of this video, so enjoy. So let's have a closer look at the Canon G5X. This is from the front. You've got a front dial which only really works when you're in manual mode, and it can adjust is the ISO or the shutter speed. You've got the on off button. You've got here is a zoom. You've got the exposure dial on here, -3 or +3. You got your shoot mode on the right hand side. You got a hot shoe on the top for flashes, for instance, like that, which is pretty handy. When you turn on, as you can see, the lens will pop out. It's a basically it's a 8.8 to 36 millimeter, basically equivalent to a 24 to 100, because it's a 1-inch sensor. So when you look into that, it's an f 1.8 wide open up to 2.8 when you're zoomed out in, should I say. So it's not a bad looking little thing. Now on the side here, you have got, let's have a look on the side. On the side we have a remote button. At first I thought that was a microphone in, which is a pity. It would have been great if it did. And you've got HDMI out, or actually USB out and HDMI out on the sides there. Hey Canon, if you're doing a Mark II of this, put a headphone jack, and this will be the absolute beast of a of a rear-locking camera. So let's have a look in the back. On the back here we have a record button, which is here, which actually looks a bit hard to press, but I'm actually finding it a lot easier to press than the Sony cameras that I've had in the past. We've got the electronic EVF here, we've got the normal screen on the back. We've got a couple buttons here, the menu, play buttons and stuff like that. And also the one thing this has got, it has got the super. And when you got here, you've got that, so for selfie mode, you can switch that around that way, and of course this way you can see it and get different angles. Or you can spin it around and just have it on the screen like so. And on the side you basically have nothing else. One interesting point is actually also down here you've got a mobile phone button. You press that and you can set this camera up with your mobile phone. That's a look at the camera. Let's go out and see what it's like on the real world going out being used. Not a bad little camera. So there we go guys, that's a look at the new Canon G5X. This is not an in-depth review. Oh, it's a lot of little specs. It does a 20 megapixel photos. I should come into that, shouldn't I? So 20 megapixels is all you need. Great for a 1-inch sensor. It doesn't do 4K, which is a bit of a pity, but you know, it's still a really good camera. It can do up to 60 frames a second in 1080p, and just as you saw, the quality from this little camera is really good. Very handy as a vlogging camera, and I really recommend checking it out. If you're looking for a vlogging camera that's a little bit more than an RX100 or the G7X. Now, I really hope that they come out with a G5X Mark II with the newer sensor, because I'm really impressed with this so far, and I'll definitely look into getting the G5X Mark II if they do come up for that. But please, can just wait until the end of the year, okay? Because I've only just got this. But yeah, really impressed with this. If you're after a good small size camera that's got some great options, definitely look into this camera. Okay guys, well, I'm Ian, this is Aussie Tech. Catch you guys all later.